Wrestling, Dave Brown, and we're right along ringside, all ready to go with another big week of championship wrestling. Goodness gracious, what a crowd.
What a crowd we got here today. Got a packed house. Glad to have him with us. Glad to have you with us. We are going to have today Sato, Goto, the Ninja will be here. Six-man tag match coming up. A little bit later on, Jeff Jarrett and Pat Tanaka will be arriving to go against the Memphis Vice. And then later on today, it'll be the return to championship wrestling of the one and only Wildfire, Tommy Rich.
You know that's going to be excitement when the Wildfire gets here. We got a lot of it lined up. We better take time out right now. We'll be back with that opening bout for you in just a moment. Okay, we're going to be looking for the King in here to go against Keith Eric. Speaking of the King, Tommy Rich and Jerry Lawler had a match with Fire and Flame where the masks were involved, and if they unmask them, Fire is Dirty Rhodes, Flame, Don Bass, and Torch was Larry Wright.
Right. Let me interrupt
you. Randy Hales, yeah.
We have a little problem. Back in the dressing room, Jerry Lawler is not here. We're going to have to move this match down in the show a little bit. Jerry's not here.
I haven't gotten here yet.
No, I've called his house. They said he left a long time ago and should be here by now. I don't know where he is. We'll just have to move this match down.
Okay, Randy, thank you. Well, that's the way to start a show off, Dave.
Yeah. No show here.
He's not here.
Well, yeah, okay. We will do that while they argue with Keith Eric up there about the whole thing. What's next? Okay, we have got an interview with Dirty Rhodes and Don Bass. We just told you about the announcement in there, so let's kind of move on to that. And be prepared. We'll do the break after this because the match will not take place. Boy, you guys look like you've been in a wreck.
Shut your mouth. You just never mind, Lance Russell. As everybody sees, Jerry Lawler is not here.
That's right, baby. Yeah.
Like I told you, brother, he is out forever. Jerry Lawler is gone. I told these people that I was going to do it. Me and Don Bass, brother, we wore those masks for a long, long time, Lawler. And you and Rich think you're smart, brother. But now you know where you are, Lawler. And Rich, let me tell you something. Does anybody recognize what I got right here? Huh?
That's the Cleveland Browns. Those are Lawler's keys.
Those aren't Lawler's keys. These are my keys, brother, because they're in my possession, you understand? And Rich, brother, your minutes are ticking down. You are next. Lawler is gone. You are next.
We're going to finish number one, baby. We're going to take care of the next just in a few minutes here.
What are you guys doing with those keys?
Somebody said we had to repossess a car, Lance Russell. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I hear what you're saying. Southern Tag Champs, Dirty Rhodes, Don Bass with Torch Larry Wright as the third man. I don't know what that was all about, but let's take a break right here, and we will be back to continue with the show, Dave. I don't know anything else to do. Here in just one moment, brother, I'll tell you, talking about action, we got it. Evansville Coliseum. One thing you're not going to see is the King, because unfortunately, just stay tuned. You'll see exactly why for an incident that took place. He's been suspended for wrestling for a week, but other action is going to be going on. Southern Tag Team title match, Dirty Rhodes, Don Bass defending against Wildfire Tommy Rich, and Pat Tanaka is his partner.
Lance Russell, these people are going to see here in a minute one of the most dastardly deeds ever did in the professional wrestling business. Jerry Lawler, you could kill somebody, hit him over the head with a Coke bottle. What if that thing is splintered went into my brain? And they suspended him for a week? For one week? They should suspended him for life from wrestling ever. Boy, you're a lunatic. But I'm going to tell you something. They got a rumor out that you're going to be right there, brother. And I hope you do show up. And I hope you got another bottle. Because it's the longest day of my life, Jerry Lawler. I'm going to get my hands on you for what you did. I can't even wear my hat.
Well, I'll tell you, it doesn't mean that he won't be in the building right there. Somebody else that's going to be there is going to be Jeff and Jerry Jarrett. Father-son action going against Akio Sato and Tarzan Goto in a pole strap match, and they intend on winning that.
I don't like to say nothing, but my cousin, Mr. Goto, has something to say. Nothing. よこの女郎だこの野郎殺したからてめえらこの野郎よく覚えてるこの野郎てめえら二人これは殺したからこの野郎バカーバカー
If I can get my microphone back I'll tell you this nobody understood what you're saying Jerry Jarrett Jeff Jarrett don't even care what you were saying because they're going to be looking forward to that match now let me tell you the final bout is going to be a 16 man tag battle royal that is going to be won for $10,000 tell you more about that in just a few minutes Okay, we got a highlight tape that I think a lot of the folks will be interested in. This was kind of as a result of a situation that occurred. It took place in the Mid-South Coliseum in Memphis, Tennessee. We've got some highlights from a Jerry Jarrett Tojo Yamamoto match. I want you to look at this. These two guys were once partners, and in addition to that, were longtime respected Southern Tag Team champions. Jerry Jarrett starts right out working on the arm. Boy, it sounded to me like his arm popped.
That's exactly what Jerry said he was going to do. He's going to break his arm.
Well, you know, I got no love for Tojo, but I'll tell you, when he put that Japanese bar on it, he's doing it again, Eddie. You know, there's a point of where it goes beyond wrestling in there.
Tojo should have thought about that in the weeks behind us, Lance. I have no sympathy for him whatsoever.
There was a distinct pop when Jerry put that Japanese arm bar. He's beating on his arm now. Yamamoto... screaming as Jerry's still pounding on the arm, pushes referee Frank Morrell back, and he is still going after it as he pulls Jarrett off. Uh-oh. Here comes Sato Goto, Jeff Jarrett, Pat Tanaka. Minute and 32 seconds. He broke his arm, Randy.
Exactly what he said he's going to do.
Here comes the ninja.
He said he'd break it, and he did.
Nobody deserved it any more than Yamamoto, the ninja being manhandled by the referee. With Sato and Tanaka down there, Jeff Jarrett and Goto and Tanaka, Sato and Jeff Jarrett. Here comes the king. Screaming in the center of the ring. Yeah, just a comment or two. That was Eddie Marlin I was talking to that came there to see it. And I want to say this right now. This is a part of the championship wrestling program we're not particularly fond of, but it is imperative. I feel that we get both sides in any kind of a situation. That is why, even after what he did last week, we're going to permit Tojo Yamamoto an opportunity to have his say. Now, I do want to say this. I have made it clear to Tojo that I am pulling, and this is no kidding with Tojo Yamamoto, and he knows I mean what I said. I will sue you. If you lay your hands on me and start beating on me, Tojo. Now, what I'm going to do is tell you that you've got a minute and a half to say what you want to say, and I'll stand here and hold the microphone.
You give me a microphone. Only one will you give a minute? Jerry Jarrett, you tried to break my arm last night. You put your best hold last night, but you never broke my arm. I was too strong. I went to doctor. Doctor said... my arm only fracture. He want to put it in cast. I don't like it because I am too strong. Jerry Jarrett, this is not the end now. This is just a starting of the war. I tell you, you're going to pay everything for this. Oh, what is that? Jerry, what are you doing? What are you doing? 記憶抜けろこの野郎、俺どころじゃねえこの野郎、肩に頼ってみろこの野郎、俺怒ってたこの野郎、我が野郎腕でも走ってもこの野郎、殺したのこの野郎、持ってる時から顔にしたのこの野郎、おい見えた後に失礼たのこの野郎、覚えてくれてねこの野郎、よくなったの俺の風に腕を折ってくれたこの野郎、覚えてねこの野郎、見ろこの痛い立ち腕をこの野郎、全員この野郎、覚えてくれてねこの野郎、何起きたくなろう、殺したくなろう。
For any of you understand Japanese, I certainly hope that that was permissible for broadcast because he did it. Okay, they're going to the ring. Sato Goto, Yamamoto, despite what he said, has got his arm in a cast in there as a result of Jerry Jarrett. They've...
Six-man tag team action coming up here. Introducing at a total weight of 670 pounds on one side of the ring, all from Memphis, Tennessee, David Haskins, Jim Jameson, and Mike Murphy. And on the other side over here, the Japanese team of Akio Sato and Tarzan Goto with their partner, the Ninja. Tojo Yamamoto, left arm in a cast, Ninja stick, kendo stick in the right hand down here at ringside. David Haskins starting against, whoa, Tarzan Goto, who was down on the mat briefly, a one count by referee Jerry Calhoun. Look out, Akio Sato jumps in there. Tag made by David Haskins, and here is Mike Murphy. Murphy battling Sato. Referee send a Tarzan Goto back out. Here comes the Ninja against Jim Jameson. Jim Jameson in after the tag by Mike Murphy. The Ninja out of the Far East, the latest in the Tojo Yamamoto stable. Oh. The Ninja with the kicks and the chop drops down on the chest to Jim Jameson. Picks him up by the hair now. Ninja with a vicious chop as Jameson came off the rope. He leaves him there for Tarzan Goto. Goto picking up where the Ninja left off, using that hard head of his. And a chop. Jameson back near the corner. He gets the tag. Mike Murphy coming in. Murphy with a good drop kick. He put Goto down as he came off the ropes. Akio Sato back in. Oh, Murphy misses the drop kick. Sato hung on to the ropes. Murphy missed and just hit the mat hard. Sato turned around. He picks him up now. Japanese team makes a tag. Tarzan Goto head to the midsection. And back with a boot across the back of the neck. Mike Murphy in trouble here. The tag made on the Ninja. There's a cover. Counts at one, two, and three. This one's over. The Ninja getting the pin on Mike Murphy. Tojo Yamamoto with that kendo stick. He just hammered Murphy in the top of the head with it. There, their hands raised, the Far Eastern team from Tokyo, Akio Sato, Tarzan Goto, and the Ninja with Tojo Yamamoto, the winners of the match.
no question about it, they just had entirely too much for the team that they were facing in here today, Haskins, Jameson, and Murphy.
Okay, coming out right now, Jeff Jarrett, Pat Tanaka, and Jerry Jarrett. Hi, Jeff. Pat, how you doing? Jerry, good to have you out here. Well, despite all the protestations about how you didn't hurt Tojo and all of that, I noticed his arm was set up in that sling.
Yeah, Lance, I really am not standing here proud that I'm a professional wrestler this morning because, to me, wrestling has been my whole life. It's something that I hope that my children would go into as Jeff has. There are situations in life that you have to go against all you've ever taught your children, and last night was one of those situations. There comes a time when people break the rules, when people try to hurt you to such an extent that you have to go against all that you believe in. And wrestling's supposed to be a sport. It's supposed to be something that I am very proud that I'm in. But with Tojo, it's gone way too far, and he had to be stopped, and he was
Amen.
Stopped.
Amen.
While I've tried to teach fair play and be an example of it myself, I also have tried to convey to my boys that there comes a time when an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth in the Old Testament are just in their ways. Sato and Goto, your time is next. We're in a match that I've asked for. I want to take this opportunity right now to thank Pat Tanaka. He's one of the finest wrestlers I know of. Pat has taken a lot of beatings at the hands of Sato and Goto and Tojo, and I know how much he would like to be in this match where he could get a chance to get that strap and give them back some of the pain that he's given them. But I asked him, I said, one time and then my task is done. I want to team with Jeff, and Pat graciously stepped aside and let me have this opportunity to take his place in this match. It's going to be Jeff and I, and there's going to be a pole, and there's going to be a strap on it. And like I said, Sato and Goto and Tojo, you got yours. It's time for y'all to get your dues, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. You're going to get a beating with that strap, and you're going to wish that you'd have never laid your hands on Jeff Jarrett. And that's a promise.
Jeff? Well, you know, Lance, my whole life I've been to the matches, and I've watched my dad, and I've always dreamed of the day that one day me and him would be partners, and the day's finally come,
yeah.
And when I get in the ring, I'm going to be really looking forward to it. And there's going to be a pole. There's going to be a strap on top of that pole. And I'm going to promise you people this, and especially my dad, we'll get that strap, and I'll give them a beat, and they'll never regret.
Okay, good luck to you guys. I am really going to be interested to see you guys working together. It will be something that will be very close to me, too, having watched Jeff grow up and known Jerry for a long, long time. We're going to take time out. We'll be back in just a moment. To tell you that first action is going to be taking place on Friday, October the 10th in Hopkinsville, Kentucky at the Western Kentucky State Fairgrounds at the Convention Center. Then on Thursday, October the 16th, Caruthersville, Indiana at Caruthersville High School, sponsor the Volunteer Fire Department. On Thursday, November the 13th, Owensboro, Kentucky at the Davis County High School. Sponsor is the Athletic Boosters Club. Thursday, November the 20th, Mount Washington, Kentucky at the Bullitt East High School. We'll have more on those as we get closer to it. Listen to the entire card. Six matches, Evansville Coliseum. Malkovich against Speedy Tall Trees. McCord and John Paul against Boy Tony and Big Bubba. Mid-America title, Tracy Smothers defends against the Ninja. Rhodes and Bass defend against Tommy Rich and Pat Tanaka. Jerry and Jeff Jarrett going against Sato and Goto in a pole strap match. And a 16-man tag battle royal for $10,000 to the winning team. Vice in the ring now. Every time I see him, I always want to read the rear end because they're a walking billboard. They've always got something new on there. Jerry Bryant says mean and nasty. I don't know what Big Lou's got on his.
So bad.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you one thing. Big Lou's got about as big a bad a mouth as anybody I ever heard. Okay, David, we're ready for the introduction.
We are indeed. This match is going to be one fall, 10-minute time limit at a total of 468 pounds on the left of your screen. The Memphis Vice, Big Lou Winston, and Jerry Bryant across the way at a total of 401. Out of Nashville, Tennessee, Jeff Jarrett, and from Hawaii, Pat Tanaka. This match, one fall, 10-minute time limit. Here the high fives by the Memphis Vice, and referee Jerry Calhoun says, let's go.
Starting out, Jerry Bryan and Jeff Jarrett, I saw these guys against each other in one previous match. And, brother, I am telling you, a whale of a clash, Dave. They get it on. We've always talked about what a cocky, show-off kind of a guy Jerry Bryan is, but we've also given him the credit for the fact that he's one of the fastest guys we've seen in the ring. Well, he's going against two guys that are just as fast as he is, and it makes an awfully, awfully good competition. They've met one time. Look at here. Nice move, Jeff Jarrett. Jerry Bryan. Around, I tell you, I cannot believe that Jeff Jarrett has been in wrestling only a matter of months. I kind of thought it was good action, Jerry. Yeah, it is. Oh, he's pulling his hair.
Crowd count with a referee. They got a 10 count to get back up there. Bryant's in there at 9. Boy, you're right. Can you imagine what Jeff Jarrett is going to look like after, say, 2 years looking this good after just a few months? Wow.
Well, we've talked about it before. You and I have seen a lot of families. The first one that comes to mind, the Gibsons, Rick and Robert. But it is a distinct advantage when you've grown up around wrestling. But I've never seen anybody who's been able to perform the feats that he can after a match. Jerry Bryant. Look at here. Drop kick Bryant and nail Lou Winston again.
Memphis Vice real upset over the situation. Just some great moves by Jeff Jarrett.
And there's the count again. He's back in there, breaks the count right at the end, and Bryant going to the referee saying, watch what he's doing. It's all illegal. Taking our hat off in a well-deserved tip of the hat to Jeff Jarrett for the amazing level he is at. The young man from Hawaii climbing through the ropes right now. What a perfect compliment. Here's a young guy, Pat Tanaka, who is also one of the classiest wrestlers using martial arts we've seen in a long time. He is very quick, very much aware of what's happening. They just make an exceptional team, Jarrett and Tanaka.
Bryant complaining. Oh, Pat Tanaka went after him as Bryant was complaining to the crowd and complaining about the crowd.
He's just getting his attention. He wrapped him in there to say, hey, come on out here and get in the ring and wrestle. Standing side headlock, Pat Tanaka with Jerry Bryant. In case you just joined us, we had a match with Jerry Lawler scheduled against Keith Eric. Jerry has not shown up at the studio as yet. He will be here, and we're going to reschedule that match a little later on, so you'll have a chance to see the King. Also, Tommy Wildfire Rich is with us today for the first time in a long time. We're looking forward to seeing Wildfire out here.
Memphis Vice not having any luck against either Jeff Jarrett or Pat Tanaka today. Jerry Bryant really, oh, look out. Sato and Goto jumping Jarrett.
Boy, wouldn't you know it.
Oh, we had a great match going on, and Itojo out here at ringside has sent the Japanese team out, and they have jumped Jarrett.
So the Memphis Vice now, is this fair? Memphis Vice over there on Pat Tanaka, Lou, and Jerry Bryant. Here comes Jerry Jarrett out. He nails Sato. Jerry pops Goto. Jeff Jarrett wheeling away. Now the ninja comes out, slams Jerry in the head, puts him down. Okay, okay.
just put a pile driver on Jeff Jarrett. Sato did. Here comes Paul Diamond. Yamamoto with that kendo stick beating on Jeff. Look at that Diamond go. The young Canadian really ripping him up. Sato with a chair. Nails Diamond right in the knee with that chair. Pat Tanaka being beaten by the Memphis Vice. Tojo killing. Hey, what? Hey, watch him. Watch him. Watch him. Sato up on a rope. They're holding Diamond. Oh, no. Come on. Paul Diamond. Goto held his leg right across that chair, and Sato came off the top rope. Now they're continuing to do it. Ninja on Jerry Jarrett. Come on, Jerry, get that. Goto with a chair. Paul Diamond. We got to get some help for this guy. Now they got Jerry Jarrett strung up. Yamamoto. With a belt. Slashing Jarrett. Here comes Eddie. Eddie Marlin out. Decks the Ninja, but Goto's right behind him.
Oh, the Japanese hit Eddie with that trash can.
Sato slammed Eddie with that trash can. He busted Eddie open. Yep, with it! Jeff has got the kendo stick on Tojo. But Eddie Marlin being destroyed up there by the Japanese. Sato just stomped on Paul Diamond's knee. Here comes Jerry Garman and Benny Traylor to help out. The Memphis Vice dispose of them. David Haskins, Jim Jamison. Takes it again right in that knee. Boy, I'll tell you, if they didn't bust that knee, I don't know what. Here comes Wildfire. Tracy Smothers with chairs, and there they go.
Legs hurt.
I'll say it. Be real careful with him. Eddie, you better get back here and get that blood. I know. He got him right in the knee. Move him real quick. Yeah. Boy, if there's any way you could roll him over, he might go easier. Okay. I tell you what we better do. Let's take a break here. And we're going to be back in just a moment. Let's take a break here.
There it is.
Yeah,
up there in the ring. Yeah, talking to the crowd.
Here it comes. Back again. Wildfire. Tommy Rich. Boy, the youngsters love him. They're over there to
greet him, welcome him back here to our championship wrestling, and climbing into the ring, ready for the introduction.
It's going to be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Introducing out of Memphis, Tennessee, at 232 pounds, Keith Robertson, and going against him, 237 pounds, out of Hendersonville, Tennessee, originally, it's Wildfire Tommy Rich. Tommy, of course, has wrestled all over the world since he left Hendersonville, Tennessee. Going in here today against Keith Robertson.
Tommy held the NWA World Heavyweight title. Took it from Harley Race. He lost it back to Harley in a return match, but there's just a lot of wrestlers that can't say that. Boy, he got a big feather. Look at him. Nice reversal.
He bars the left arm. Pretty well in control so far. Yeah, a little pressure he puts on Keith Robertson. You can see Robertson felt it, too. Tommy Rich. He's still hanging on. Referee checking with Robertson about a possible submission. Robertson so far has said, nope, he's hanging in there, not giving it up. May change his mind if Tommy Rich keeps that kind of pressure on there for very long.
Tommy had it tight, too. It was a beautiful combination of angles he had. Trips him back down. I'm sure there's a high-class wrestling term for it, but what he did was trip him back down. That's just what he did. Tommy!
Nice snap. Puts him down. Count of one. One count is all he gets. Robertson able to kick out of it at one. Oh, look out. Here it comes. Here comes Dirty Rhodes, Don Bass, and Larry Wright, formerly Fire, Flame, and Torch. They grabbed Tommy. He just hit him with a chain.
Yeah, he
had a chain wrapped around
himself. Yeah, he did.
And now Dirty Rhodes has that chain.
So what we've got is 3-on-1. Robertson, who had taken a pounding from Tommy in the early part of it, they got Tommy busted open.
Wide open.
Oh, man, I guess. Get him out of there, Jerry.
Well, Dirty Rhodes, we thought, was out of the ring, but he just went out to get a chair, and here he is back.
Blazes Rich with that chair. Rhodes and Bass were scheduled in the next tag team match, but they made an early appearance here as they are slaughtering Tommy Rich in the center of the ring up there. It's 3-on-1, and the referee, ineffective as far as breaking him up. I'm not blaming him, because when you got guys that big, and boy, let me tell you, all three of these guys are large, large.
Tommy they have really just worked him over constantly here for about 2 minutes now. Eddie Marlin says if they don't get out of the ring right now, they are suspended.
Eddie, who got busted up a little earlier, tells referee Jerry Calhoun that if they don't get out of the ring right now, they are suspended. I think that may get their attention, too. Dirty Rhodes, Don Bass, and Larry Wright. That's Wright, who was Torch.
He's the one that had the chain wrapped around his hand when they jumped into the ring there. And he...
Boy, Tommy, man, oh, man, is he...
What I say, Lance Russell, get that camera right here quick, brother. And I want you to look at this right here. Yeah. Right, here's the other one right there. Look, I told you we'd kill him before the day was over. Did I tell you that?
Yeah.
Now Lawler's gone, brother. And now Rich. Look at you, Rich. Look at you, boy.
Put the camera on the ring.
Put the camera back on the ring. That's right. Because when we left Lawler this morning, he looked worse than that.
That's marvelous. You guys are great, genuine specimens of humanity.
What did I say, Lance Russell?
What is that?
He messed with Fire and Flame.
or Don Rhodes, or Bass, brother. That's what happens to you.
Tell him, killer.
Bass meant a lot to us, and we will not stand for it.
Okay.
Get him out of the ring. Who's that opponent now, baby? We're going to do the same thing to him.
I love it, man. I love it.
Look out, Jerry, around behind here. Dirty Rhodes picks up a chair and heads toward the general direction of where they're trying to get Tommy Rich out of there. Referee Jerry Calhoun saw him coming there. Thank goodness.
Boy, he was totally covered up with blood, too. They beat him silly with that chain in there. And now referee Jerry Calhoun trying to make a point to them. They don't have to worry about wrestling another match. They don't hold off and get out. Eddie Marlin's already told them they're subject to suspension if they didn't get out of that ring. Tommy, they got him back on his feet. He went down again. They're trying to help him back out of there. Referee Jerry Calhoun keeping him apart. Don Bass and Dirty Rhodes are scheduled to go against Gary Garmin and Benny Trailer. I sure don't think I want to be Garmin and Trailer.
Just the God, baby. Just the God.
Okay, we're either going to have to get this match underway or we're going to have to get it on with, we got plenty of action yet to go. Here comes Jerry Garmin and Benny Trailer. And right away.
I'm going to get this match in a minute, but I want these people to understand, brother, that when you mess with Don Bass and Dirty Rhodes, you're messing with the best in professional wrestling.
Some more horn blowing from Dirty Rhodes as Don Bass is up there on Jerry Garmin. Don goes after Benny Trailer.
Larry Wright, now Larry Wright.
Yeah.
Rolling him back in the ring. Garmin and Trailer both down to the mat. The referee was down there for a moment. He's back on his feet. Out of the ring goes, I think that was Benny Trailer that was thrown out of the ring. That's Jerry Garmin in there right now. Dirty Rhodes flips him high in the air with a backdrop.
Bass and Rhodes and Larry Wright lost their mask, and they're taking it out on the world in there. They lost it in a fair contest with Lawler and Tommy Rich, and now, well, you can only guess what Rhodes, Bass, and Wright have done with Lawler.
Yeah, but Rhodes still showing off those car keys with a Cleveland Browns keychain on him. He was just very proud of that. There's a cover, one. Oh, he picks him up. Didn't even try for the three count. Picks Garmin up by the hair. Jerry trying to get to the corner and tag Benny Trailer. Didn't get there. Dirty Rhodes, Don Bass, former Fire and Flame.
Get some mad when you see guys like Rhodes and Bass and Larry right here and Sato and Goto and Yamamoto and they're in a match and they have a chance to win the thing and they just want to punish somebody. I just want to ring the bell. It's not in our province to do that. There's a 1-2-3 finally.
I got it. 2:03 the time on it.
Jerry Garmin, Benny Trailer, a good, tough young team, but boy, they are certainly no match for the likes.
Yeah, Dirty Rhodes, Don Bass, and Larry Wright, all of them together there.
They end up winning, what was it, 2:03?
Simon, it was 2:03, And they could have done it quicker if they wanted to.
Well, I don't know what he's doing over there, grabbing hats and all. I want to tell you.
Bring it over here, Les. Bring it over here.
Yeah, it wasn't like it was any one man did it. Three of you jumped on Tommy Rich out there.
Les Russell, let me tell you something right now. I'm going to put these glasses on because my future is so bright that it's shining in here, you understand? So excuse me. Now what I want to know, Eddie Marlin, if you've got anybody left alive in the back, who is our opponent? That's what I want to know.
Uh-oh. Wait a minute.
comes in with Tommy Rich. Tommy Rich over here with Larry Wright and Don Bass. Oh, yeah, get the cameras out of the way. They have absolutely gone berserk. I can't say that I blame them. Lawler, a mess. He is bleeding, clothes torn. Obviously, the three of them jumped Lawler. Evidently jumped Lawler and beat him up. They must have jumped you, Jerry.
Let me tell you something. Takes real tough guys. Takes somebody real tough for three men to run somebody off the road and do this to them. That's real big guys. But they ain't so damn tough when it's two on two, are they, Lance? I'm not going to stand for this, I guarantee you. When I get my hands on you, when I get in the ring, I'm not going to stop with busting your heads. I'm going to kill you. Somebody say something.
We better take time out here and get some of this glass up and all that. We'll be back.
Whoa, yeah, Wednesday night, I'm talking about the Great Wars coming to the Coliseum right there in Evansville, Indiana, brother. Six matches, and I mean, they are outstanding. By the way, in case you haven't heard, due to an incident that took place on this show, Jerry Lawler has been suspended for wrestling for 1 week. Now, that, of course, means he won't be wrestling Wednesday night in the Evansville Coliseum, but there's nothing in that suspension that says he can't be there, so I'll leave it to your own imagination. He may or may not be with us right there at the Evansville Coliseum. We're going to be seeing a Mid-America defense, Tracy Smothers against the Ninja, Southern Tag Team defense with Dirty Rhodes and Don Bass against Pat Tanaka and Wildfire Tommy Rich. Be hearing from him in just a second. Pole strap match with Jerry and Jeff Jarrett. What a dandy that's going to be to see that father and son team together against Sato and Goto with Tojo out there at ringside and a 16-man tag team battle royal for 10 grand. Here's Tommy. Let's listen.
You know, the king ain't here because you had him suspended. But you know, you laid my head open, beat my brains half out. You know, I was glad he busted you over the head with that bottle. And we're talking about Pat Tanaka and myself. We're coming after you, Dirty Rhodes, Don Bass. Y'all better be ready because you're going to live to regret the day that you ever got Lawler suspended. Because like I said, Lawler and me, we ain't seen eye to eye on a lot of things. But this, we see dead eye together. Y'all had him suspended a week. Well, it'll be Pat Tanaka and myself, and we're coming for blood. We're coming for the straps, and the main thing, you know, Tommy Rich has been known to get crazy a lot of times, and this may be one of them times because I don't think Lawler was wrong. Y'all better be ready. I may be suspended.
Believe Tommy is fired up, ready to go. You better believe it. He'll be right in there going with Pat Tanaka, and that could be a rugged challenge for Rhodes and Bass on those Southern Tag titles. Just one of the many big bouts that are coming. When Wednesday night, Evansville, Indiana. See you there. Well, let's bring them out here. We haven't had the opportunity to see these two guys together on Championship Wrestling ever. We've had Rick McCord here once before. And coming out prior to their match, there's their opponents heading out there, rough and ready with Boss Winter. Rick McCord, John Paul. That is McCord in front and John Paul in behind. Rick is from Salem, Virginia.
Rick, it's been a while, partner.
Great to be back.
John Paul, welcome to Championship Wrestling. Our first time to see you here. Glad to see you guys together.
You know, I've been on the road for a long time. It's been a while since I've been here. Everywhere I've been, all you hear about this is a hotbed for tag team wrestling. When I was here before, I was always in singles, but I went out, I scouted around, and I found me a partner that I can count on, John Paul. And I tell you what, we're here to make a name, to get a championship belt, and you just watch.
Now, you can tell, John, from what you've already seen on Championship Wrestling, you better be ready to fight when you're here.
That's right. I'm ready. I've worked hard, and here we are. Let's go, brother.
Okay. John Paul, Rick McCord. We'll be interested to see him in the ring. Good-looking young team, Dave.
They are indeed. They're going against the team of Rough and Ready out of Parts Unknown. Boss Winter is in their corner. Rick McCord again out of Salem, Virginia. John Paul is out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Their total weight at 444. Rough and Ready's total weight at 422. That is referee Jerry Calhoun standing right square in the middle of the screen. He is set to go, and we get one on either team in the ring. The rest of them out on the apron. The bell will sound. There it goes, and our expiration of time match is underway. Rick McCord starting for his team against Rough. We're Rough and Ready.
Yes, sir, it is always rugged when you step into the ring with Championship Wrestling. You not only have to battle your opponent, but, brother, I'm going to tell you, when you got the likes of Bass and Rhodes and Sato and Goto and Yamamoto and so forth around, you never know what's going to happen to your back. Rick McCord.
Quick tags by McCord and John Paul. Good tag team strategy.
Paul is the larger of the two. Picks Ruff up in the air and batters him off the mat. Tag on Rick McCord.
Double chop by McCord and John Paul. There's a cover right over very close to the corner, and Ready from outside breaks it up. Rough stays in there, though. We're coming up about a minute and a half into this first fall of action. Rick McCord stepping out of the ring. John Paul will be coming back in to take over from Rick McCord. And McCord, they double him into the end of the ropes. Set him up. John Paul unloaded with a clothesline as he came off of there. Now he picks him up in the air. Power slam down to the mat. Tag is made, and Rick McCord coming back in. McCord, whoa. John Paul just picks him up in the air and drops him down. Count is one, two, and three. 2 minutes, 46 seconds of action. And the team of Rick McCord and John Paul in their debut here on Championship Wrestling have themselves a victory in the fall.
Very tight team, too. They didn't waste a lot of motion in there. And when they had him, boy, they just pressed him up and dropped him down. And bango, that was it. Got to 1-2-3, and Rough and Ready, we're not ready for that engagement. We're going to take time out, and we'll be back in just a moment. Line that we've used a million times that I've said Mama told me there were going to be days like this is applicable to this day.
This was one of them, I tell you. I know you just never know what's going to be coming down the pike next when you watch Championship Wrestling.
Summarize what happened today in 30 seconds.
Well, I can't do it justice in the time that we have here. Sato and Goto and the Ninja won the six-man tag team match today. Jeff Jarrett, Pat Tanaka, winners by disqualification, but they were winners when the Japanese came in here, Tojo and all of them in here, started beating up on them. So a disqualification occurred, and that's how Jeff and Pat won it. Then we had this wild free-for-all going with all sorts of things happening.
Yes.
Ended up Paul Diamond getting his leg hurt.
Paul's knee is hurt bad.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Finally, we got that one out of here. Tommy Rich came in. He defeated Keith Robertson by disqualification, but it was the former Fire and Flame that jumped him. It went on from there. Let me just say, Rick McCord and John Paul, a new team, won their match in a wild, wild day of action.
We'll finish it next week.
All right.
For Dave Brown, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship.